Good morning to all doing well. You're all safe at your homes, along with your parents and grandparents and everybody at home. Children, this is your GK class. Now, last week, we did first, second, and third chapter. And today, I'm going to do fourth and fifth chapter with you. There are only four pages, okay? So, but that's something very interesting we are going to learn about, okay, today. So, page number 12 of your books, and that is chapter 4, and that is unusual animal defense mechanisms. Unusual means something which is not ordinary, something which is not common. Okay, that is unusual. Usual is something common. And unusual is something extraordinary, something which is not usual, something which is not common. Then animal, of course, we are going to learn about animals, defense mechanisms. Now defense, what do you mean by defense? Defense is when somebody attacks you, you save yourself, you protect yourself. So that is your defending yourself. That is your defense mechanism. Okay. So all the animals, they also have some or the other kind of defense mechanisms, because there is always a fear of them being attacked by some other creature, some other animal. So now, some of these animals have really unusual defense mechanisms. That means they have unusual, uncommon ways of saving themselves, of protecting themselves when they are attacked by another creature. Okay, so we'll study about that. So I will share the PDF with you. Okay. So here you can see. Okay. Unusual animal defense mechanisms. Animals have developed various defense tactics in the course of their evolution. Most animals simply flee from their predators. What is the simplest defense mechanism? Is to flee. That means to run away. We humans also run away sometimes when we see danger. So that is your defense mechanism. Like you must have seen those people who are driving two-wheelers and they don't wear helmets. And they see that the police is standing there checking. Okay. And making challans. So what is their defense mechanism? Those people without helmets, what they do is they quickly move their bike from there and they take another turn and run away from there. Okay, instead of going ahead on the same road. So what is generally the characteristic? We generally flee. We generally run away. Now, depending on the habitat of the organism, habitat is where an organism lives. Okay, the surrounding, the place where he lives. So the habitat of the organism and the nature of its body structure. What kind of body structure does the animal have? There is a wide range of other defense strategies that animals use. So running away is something usual, something common, but many animals, they have unusual defense tactics. Okay. Apart from the mechanisms named below, animals also use other unique ways of defense. Some use alarm calls that are specific to the nature of their danger. Some use zigzagging ways of flight to escape the predator. Some animals, like the cicadas, emerge from their underground homes only once in 13 to 17 years. So animals like cicadas, they come out of their homes, underground homes, only in 13 to 17 years, because it's very easy to kill them. They might come under your feet also and they may get killed. So they don't come out of their homes only. So these are the defense mechanisms. Now we'll study about some more of them. Now name the defense mechanisms used in the following cases. Okay, so the Texas horned lizard shoots blood from the eyes to startle an attacker. Animals like the squid fire a spray of ink at the predator. What is predator? Predator is the attacker, the one who attacks. That is the predator. And why would somebody attack? To eat that animal, and that animal doesn't want to die. So what he did? So what these Texas horned lizards, what do? As soon as there is an attacker, they feel that, they understand that, what they do is they shoot blood from their eyes. So the attacker is startled. Startled means totally alarmed, shocked. Okay. And then there is squid. Then squid, what does it do? It sprays a fire of ink. Okay. Sorry. They fire a spray of ink. Okay. So they spray ink and at the attacker, and then they run away. So till the attacker is able to come to the senses back, the squid is already gone. Now, when frightened, the opossum falls down as if in a coma. We learned about opossum in third chapter also. So when frightened, the opossum falls down as if in a coma. This fools the attacker into thinking that their prey is already dead. So as you can see in the picture, it's lying dead. So, okay. First of all, the answer to the first one is surprise. Okay, this is called surprise. This defense mechanism is called surprise. S-U-R-P-R-I-S-E. Now, the second one, the opossum's defense mechanism, it is called acting. Okay, he acts. What he does is, as soon as he feels he's being attacked, so he just acts as if he's in a coma. So, the other person thinks, the attacker thinks that this animal is already dead, and so they leave opossum there only. So this is called acting. Now, third one, the sight of a shoal of fish can confuse predators. The fish near the center of the shoal are much likelier to survive. Now, what is this shoal of fish? When you learned collective nouns, yes, I am connecting it to English. So shoal of fishes, children, I told you about collective nouns, and a group of fishes, that is called shoal of fish. Okay, so the sight of a shoal of fish means when you see a shoal of fish, that can confuse predators, because predator would think which fish to attack. But now in this case, what happens is the fishes which are in the center, they are more protected, and the fishes which are at the end of the group, they definitely can be attacked easily. Okay, so what is this called? This is called large groups. Okay, this is called large groups. Now, animals like the porcupine use barbed quills on their bodies to deter prey. You must have seen them in cartoons and in stories. This porcupine, it has many quills on their body, okay, so that the prey runs away, because they poke into their bodies. So this is called defensive body structure. That means their body structure is like that. Their body is already made like that. It has quills on it, and so it's not easy to attack a porcupine. Okay, so this is called defensive body structures. D-E-F-E-N-S-I-V-E, defensive body, S-T-R-U-C-T-U-R-E-S, structures. Okay, fifth one. Predators learn to avoid eating creatures whose flesh is toxic, like the puffer fish. Now, puffer fish, as the name suggests, what does it do? A puffer fish, when it sees that there is some danger, there is someone attacking, so what this does is it puffs itself, okay, like a balloon. It puffs itself and it becomes double or triple its size. So it looks like a balloon. So it's very difficult to attack it. Okay. And then pufferfish is toxic also. Toxic means poisonous. So the predators already know sometimes that this is a toxic one and they do not attack. So this is called chemical use. Okay. Okay. Next. Some animals live underground or lead a nocturnal lifestyle to escape detection. Others may blend in with their surroundings. So some animals, what they do is live underground. We just read about cicada. Then, or lead a nocturnal lifestyle to escape detection. That means they come out only at night. Okay. Then others may blend in with their surroundings. There are some other animals which just blend in. They had some kind of body structure that they blend in where they live. As you can see here, this butterfly sort of a thing, it is on a tree and it is just blended with the tree itself. Okay. So it's not easy to detect where actually that particular animal is, and so it is hard to attack. So what is this defense mechanism called? Avoidance of detection. Avoidance of detection. Detection is to find out. Okay. So they are not able to be detected easily. So avoidance of detection. Now, seventh one. Some animals lose parts of their body to give them time to escape from predators. So what do some animals do? They lose some part of their body so that the predator is confused. It keeps on seeing the part and the animal at that time runs away. We have seen when we kill lizards at our home. So lizards, you must have seen you may observe later on that if you try to kill a lizard, it sometimes leaves its tail behind. Okay. So the tail is lying there. The tail keeps on moving after being cut also. It keeps on moving and the lizard runs away. So this is called sacrifice of body parts. Okay, sacrifice of body parts. Now, the stripes on zebras running in herds can make it difficult for predators to choose their prey. Now, when zebras, there are some animals, when they see that they are being attacked, so what they do is they start running in groups. So when they run in groups, and especially zebras, they have linings on their body. So it's very difficult when they run all together. It's very difficult to identify one from another. And then it's difficult to choose who is the particular one who should be attacked. Which particular one should be attacked. So that is one defense mechanism, and that is called patterns on fur. They have a pattern on fur, and that is why when they run, it's difficult to differentiate one from another. They all look like something together. They don't look, you can't find one animal, you can't differentiate one animal from another. So this is called patterns on fur. Now, okay. Now we move on to this is your page number 12 done. See this. In an extreme case of unselfish behavior, some animals sacrifice themselves to save the entire group. Such a lovely thing. Some animals to save the entire group. They sacrifice themselves. If there is a whole group, then they may sacrifice themselves. They may go to the predator, let the predator attack that particular animal. So the whole group is saved. So this is seen in the Malaysian exploding ant. Okay. Which explodes when attacked. Spraying irritating and sticky substances on its prey, their supreme sacrifice alerts the rest of the group. So there is Malaysian exploding ant. What it does is when it is attacked, okay, then it explodes itself. When it explodes, there is a sticky, irritating substance coming out of it, which irritates the prey. Okay, it gets, it is already sticky. So when it explodes, the other ants, they get the message and they are alert and they run away from there. But definitely one of the ant has to explode, and so it is no more. It has to sacrifice itself. So such a kind gesture. Okay, now we move on to the, we have done page number 12 and 13. That means we have done chapter number 4. Now we'll move on to chapter number 5, that is famous Indian brands. Okay, now branding is the process involved in creating a unique name and image for a product or service in the consumer's mind. So why is branding done? You all love to buy branded items. Brand means you have a particular, that particular name and that particular logo is very popular, and you want to have that particular logo on your clothes and watches and shoes and all. Okay, so branding is a process involved in creating a unique name and image for a product or service in the consumer's mind. Consumer is who? We all are consumers. Okay, because we buy things. One who buy things is a consumer. Okay, so consumers, they just see the different advertisements and then they decide that which is the brand I want to have. Branding helps to identify and differentiate one product from other products in the market. So when you name them, when you brand them, that okay, this is a Tata car or this is a Ford. Okay, so when you name these, when you brand these items, then the people are able to choose, okay, better. They are able to decide which brand to choose. Once a brand has created positive sentiment among its target audience, who is the target audience? The target audience is the people. Okay, because people are going to buy the products. Okay, so this brand, when good advertisement is done, when the services are good, then a positive sentiment, a positive feeling is created in the hearts of people. And then the company is said to have built brand equity. And this is called brand equity. Okay. The company builds brand equity. That means it is able to create a feeling in the customers that, yes, this is a good brand and it should be bought. Sometimes a brand has a mascot that is immediately identified with the brand. So yes, we have the mascot or we have the logos. Sometimes celebrities can lend their faces to a brand. Yes, there are many advertisements where you can see these celebrities, they act in the advertisements and they actually advertise for those brands. Okay. Small songs called jingles are also used to identify a brand. Yes, we okay. So we do connect with jingles, children. These jingles are the songs which are sung and we really love them. Okay, so that song which is played, So Gaya Ye Jahan. Okay, so that is played for some product and we really like that. Okay, and then song that song Koi Yahan Nache Nache, that has become a jingle, okay, for a particular brand of clothes. So okay, so now यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द कंपनीज नेम यूजिंग द लोगोज एंड टैगलाइंस. तो फर्स्ट वन इज, दिस वन इज फॉर जेट एयरवेज. ओके, जेट एयरवेज. एंड व्हाट इज द टैगलाइन? द टैगलाइन इज द जॉय ऑफ flying. Okay, you have to learn this tagline, the joy of flying. Second one is TCS. TCS is beyond the obvious. TCS is beyond the obvious. Okay, okay, then we have, oh, you all love this, thumbs up, taste the thunder. So what is the tagline? Taste the thunder, thumbs up. Then when you got to go, you got to go. What is this? Red bus. Okay, red bus. Then we have Biocon, the difference lies in our DNA. Okay, that is the tagline, the difference lies in our DNA. This is Biocon. Now next is making tomorrow better. This is ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Commission. So making tomorrow better, ONGC. Okay, next, Cafe Coffee Day. This is Born Tough. Born Tough, Cafe Coffee Day. Then the Complete Man, Raymond's. Of course we all know about that, Raymond's, the Complete Man. Now okay, name the Indian companies identified by the following company mascots. So Amul, yes, we all know this is the Amul girl. Then second is Indian Railway. This is the mascot for Indian Railway, an elephant carrying a lantern. Then this is for Air India. This is for Air India. This dancing girl is for Nirma. Okay, she is in white clothes. Nirma is a washing powder. Then this is Vodafone. Okay, Vodafone. Then this one is, sixth one is MRF tires. Sixth one is MRF tires. Seventh is Asian Paints. And eighth is Sunfeast. Okay, eighth is Sunfeast. Okay, the famous high-end iconic British car brands Jaguar and Land Rover have been bought by Tata Motors. The famous Nike brand symbol represents the wings and speed of the Greek goddess of victory, not a tick mark. Yes, so good information. That Nike brand with a tick mark, that's not a tick mark, that is a representation of the wings and speed of the Greek goddess of victory. Okay, so that's now we have done the four pages. Now I want to tell you something, children. Of course, in your paper, we are not going to give you these pictures and ask you about these company mascots. We may do it if it's an online exam, but in offline, we are not going to give it. But what you need to do is, wait a minute. Yes, these taglines. We may not give you these logos, but we may definitely give you taglines. Like we can give you a tagline, Born Tough. And you have to answer that the tagline is of Cafe Coffee Day. If we give you the tagline, the Complete Man, then you have to write Raymond's. Okay. Then the tagline, making tomorrow better for ONGC, the difference lies in our DNA, Biocon. And so all the different taglines you have to remember, children. Okay, you have to learn these taglines, the joy of flying, Jet Airways. So you have to learn them. Okay, and here we are going to give you the information that the animal who leads a nocturnal life, some animal, when they blend in with their surroundings, what is this defense mechanism called? So that is avoidance of detection. Okay, Some animals lose parts of their body to give them time to time escape from predators. What is this called? What is this defense mechanism called? So this is sacrifice of body parts. Okay. So you must know them. Okay. Or we may also give you the exercise like write the defense mechanism, write the name of the defense mechanism related to the following animals. So we may tell you, like we may give you porcupine. Okay, write the name of the defense mechanism used by these creatures, by these animals. So we may give you porcupine and then you have to answer defensive body structure. We may give you puffer fish and you will write chemical use. We may give you zebra and then you will write patterns on fur. Okay, so we will write shoal of fish and the answer would be large groups. So this way we can also give you the questions from this exercise. So you have to be prepared in every way. Okay, so that's all for today, children. We have done chapter number 4 and 5. So please do all the exercises nicely. Do it with pen, blue gel pen. Okay, write all the words, all the spellings correctly, nicely, clearly, and learn them. Okay, so that's all for today. And we'll meet tomorrow in the next class of GK. So till we meet next time, just take care of yourselves and everyone around. Be happy and keep safe.